Está fallando la máquina. The engine is misfiring. How can I tell? My trouble code said P0303. The big question is, which is number three? Here's a little trick. I take the license plate number, I go to the O'Reilly website, and there where it says add vehicle, you put in the license plate, and it tells you the year, the make, the model, the submodel, and the engine, and information about the fuel system. So you know that you're working with the right information. I did that already. I Googled it, but what do you Google? In this case, 2005 Honda Pilot 3.5 firing order. That's the key word, firing order. You'll come up with images, and of course I'll put it on the screen so you can see. We're gonna concentrate on cylinder number three. There's three kinds of misfire. A dead miss, that means it is completely unfunctional all the time. We're gonna try and figure it out. The second kind of miss is a partial miss, sometimes called a weak miss, where it's not as strong as it should be. The third kind of miss is an intermittent miss. One minute it works, and the next second it doesn't. It intermittently cuts out. Now here's how we began to narrow it down. I asked the customer if the light was blinking, and she said no. When the light blinks, that is a severe miss. That's a dead miss. That's a constant miss. Okay, I'm gonna start the engine. I'm gonna put it in gear. I'm gonna feel the steering wheel. I'm gonna see how smooth it is. And then, while I'm holding the brake, I'm gonna give it a little bit of throttle to put the engine under a load, and I'm gonna see if it starts to cut out a little bit. Remember, we've got a P0303 misfire code. That means number three. Let's go on. I've got it in gear. I'm feeling for a vibration or a shake. It's pretty smooth. Now, with the brake firmly held, I'm gonna give it a little throttle. I'm feeling. Technicians, we use almost all our senses. We hear, we see, we smell, we feel. Which one did I leave out? The taste. I can taste that misfire. No, I don't feel any shaking. I don't hear any vibration. There is not a miss at this time. Let's go to my favorite place, the hood, like under the hood. Okay, folks, here it is. The COP, C-O-P, coil on plug. The first step is to take it out. Unfortunately, number three is out of the camera view, but I'm giving you an idea what we're doing out there in the back. I'll take off that one bolt and I'll pull the coil out. I have installed the homemade spark tester. I'll put the link in the description so you can see how to make and use your spark tester. I removed the coil from the spark plug and I'm getting ready to test the coil. Now I need to start the engine. I hope you can see the spark at the spark plug. We let it run for about 10 or 15 seconds and we want a consistent spark, 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 spark. This coil is good. I'm removing the spark plug. I noticed it was a little loose. That could cause a problem. The customer stated that they had new spark plugs installed about 10 months ago. Yes, it does look new. I'm looking at this spark plug to see if I see anything wrong with it. And no, I don't. There's no fuel built up. There's no oil built up. That's good. I'm going to have to do another test, but it's going to get a little loud, so I'm going to tell you ahead of time what's going to happen. I'm going to put this spark plug on that coil, and then I'm going to start the engine. I expect this spark plug to spark, but I also am going to listen. I don't have a compression gauge with me. I know it might be a little unprofessional, but I'm just going to listen, and it's going to get pretty loud, and I might just yell over it. Okay, folks, here we go. I'm going to start the engine. I expect you to see the spark, but I also want you to listen to the compression. Okay, start the engine. Okay, Yes, it was sparking. The spark plug is good. Let's summarize. We checked the coil. It was good. We checked the spark plug. It was good. The ignition is good. We kinda checked the compression. I didn't put a gauge to it, but I can tell that cylinder has decent compression. We need three things for that cylinder to combust. We need spark, we need mixture, and we need compression. Through a process of elimination, spark and compression, our focus now is on the mixture, as in the air-fuel mixture. Because it's a partial, I'm going to recommend to the customer a good fuel cleaner. I like Berryman. We're going to put a couple of doses in the fuel tank and instruct her to add another one when it's time to put a little bit more fuel. That's probably going to take care of the miss. Folks, thank you for sticking around. We appreciate it. If you enjoyed this video, that thumbs up is so important. Comments are also important to us. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. Thank you again.